Have you ever wondered how snails grow their shells when they are so hard? Firstly, the main component of a snail shell is similar to the chalk sticks teachers often use to write on blackboards at school. It is calcium carbonate. Not only the snail shell, but the shells of mollusks in general, such as clams, oysters, and abalones, are primarily composed of calcium carbonate. Essentially, these shells are the exoskeletons of mollusks, serving to support and protect their soft internal organs. The shells of mollusks, in general, do not have a cellular structure, much like a house that isn't built from bricks. At first glance, this might seem counterintuitive because we know that the growth and size of an organism, including human development, occurs through a process called cell division. An increase in the number of cells leads to growth in size. However, species like clams, oysters, snails, and mussels have figured out a way to grow their shells. By filtering hundreds of liters of water from ponds, lakes, rivers, and seas each day, they obtain food and calcium carbonate minerals to build their shells. Snails grow like a house under construction. However, while your house is built once, a snail's house is built for a lifetime. Specifically, the outermost mantle tissues on the bodies of mollusks, located right beneath and in contact with the shell, continuously secrete protein and calcium carbonate at the outermost edges, causing the shells to expand and grow along with the internal organs. The shell formation process in mollusks is quite similar to pouring concrete, where protein molecules act like rebar, determining the shape and helping to form the shell layers. Calcium carbonate, like cement, binds with the protein molecules, filling gaps and creating hardness. In terms of composition, snail shell contain over 95% calcium carbonate, with the remaining portion consisting of proteins and polysaccharide compounds. Structurally, mollusk shells generally have three layers. The outermost layer is rough, often forming nodules or sharp spines, and is mainly composed of protein. The calcium carbonate in the middle layer binds with protein to form calcite crystals, one of the crystalline structures, or in other words, one of the ways in which the atoms of the calcium carbonate molecule are arranged in three-dimensional space. Each arrangement creates a crystal with unique properties, and the calcite in seashells is fundamentally similar to the calcite in fossilized chalk. The innermost layer consists of calcium carbonate bound with a different protein, forming another crystalline structure called aragonite. Each aragonite layer is separated by an organic material layer, usually chitin, a polysaccharide compound, or various types of protein. Such structures are called nacre. Nacre is smooth, iridescent, and is the material that makes up pearls, which is why it is often referred to as mother of pearl. The details of nacre formation are still not well understood by scientists. It's important to note that not all mollusk shells have an innermost nacreous layer. In fact, most mollusk species lack this nacreous layer. To differentiate, only shells with a shiny, iridescent inner layer, like those of pearl oysters or pearl mussels. According to Wikipedia, species in the family Haliotidae, Trochidae, and Turbinidae also have shells with nacreous inner layers. Additionally, like the growth rings on the trunks of trees, which help determine the age of a tree, the shells of many mollusks, such as clams and oysters, have growth lines. The difference is that these lines are not used to determine age, but to identify living conditions over different periods. When the living environment is favorable and rich in minerals, shell formation occurs continuously, and the growth lines appear closer together and denser. Continuing with shells in mineral-rich waters like seas and oceans, marine snails and their friends secrete a large amount of calcium carbonate, creating thick and heavy shells. On the other hand, their freshwater relatives, living in mineral-poor environments, have significantly thinner shells. Another reason why marine snail shells are thicker and heavier than those of their freshwater or land-dwelling relatives, like pond snails or land snails, is the pressure of survival. Marine snails constantly face the impact of ocean waves, causing them to collide with rocks and coral. Species with thinner shells likely went extinct after being repeatedly smashed against rocks by countless waves. From the analysis above, we see that mollusks are not only delicious and nutritious, but also incredibly smart and creative. Additional information for you. According to a study titled Designing Brains for Pain, Human to Mollusk, published by the National Library of Medicine, the research team concluded that not only snails but mollusks, in general, lack the ability to feel pain because their nervous systems lack the necessary structures to do so. Hopefully, This research will make you feel less guilty the next time you eat clams, oysters, or mussels.